Make sure your vitamin D levels are also on point, because a lot of people take vitamin D for granted and never check up on their levels. Even if you're in a place with a lot of sunlight, your vitamin D levels could still be low. But especially when you come to Europe with the lack of sunlight, it will definitely dip. Just do a blood test, see what the levels are, because it helps with immunity as well. Another thing is realizing that sometimes in some countries, the Sundays are completely off. So if you want to get groceries and stuff, nothing is going to be possible because all the shops would be closed. And if you're lucky, maybe a grocery shop or two could be open. That's like not a part of a main franchise or a main retail store. But even then, it's always advisable to stock up on your groceries, maybe on Saturday or Friday when you have some time off, so that you don't go through the entirety of your Sunday without anything to cook. Because if you don't cook during your weekends, it's a waste, I would say. Much better to do it when you have downtime from day to night, as opposed to when you come back from university or from work and then make some time to cook afterwards, because you're just gonna be drained. And if you have to study as well, it's gonna eat away at a lot of that time spent grinding for that which matters. These are some of the pointers that I would have for someone planning to come to Europe, especially if you have no idea about how things are.